Hi, Kevin from Snow Is Outdoors here, and this is a DC50-X upright fridge from Bushman.
Hit it.
So this fridge runs on 12 or 24 volt, is ideal for caravans, camper vans, and motorhomes, and has a separate freezer and adjustable shelves. Okay, before we continue, make sure you like and subscribe because we have a whole lot more to see on our channel. Now let's get into it. Now this fridge weighs in at about 16.5 kilos. It is 38 centimeters wide, it is 49 centimeters deep, and it's 52.5 centimeters tall. Now around here you've got this little flange. There's about another 2 centimeters both sides and at the top for that. Because you fit this into a cabinet, allow at least another 0.5 centimeter for width, 0.5 centimeter for the height, and also at the back, probably allow about another 2 centimeters. That way you've got a good airflow keeping things cool. Now the cabinet itself is all steel. You can see it's all steel here. The sides are both the sides are the same. You've got some insulation there, and at the back you've got your electrics, your little cooling fan there to keep the thing cool. And you've got your compressor here. Now this is a Secop BD35 compressor. It draws between 2 and 5 amps. It'll average about 1 amp per hour when it's running. If you look down here, we've got the wiring. Now these bridges have to be hardwired in to 12 or 24 volt, and always make sure you've got a fuse and line just to protect the unit. Now let's have a look at the front of the fridge. Now this door can be either left-hand or right-hand hinge. It does involve undoing the screws from this top hinge here and the bottom hinge and repositioning them over this side to where the holes are already there. Now the front panel can also be removed, and that involves taking this bottom trim off, taking the panel out and fitting another panel of your choice of color. You might want to patch the plywood in your van. Now you can move the handle from this side to that side, which you would do if you were changing the hinge around. It does involve removing the sticker and taking some screws out, repositioning them over there, but just to make sure you're doing it right, just check your workshop manual. This comes with the fridge and it'll explain to you exactly how it's done. Now looking inside the fridge, we first of all, we open it up, we undo that catch by pushing it down, and the door opens up. Now looking inside, you've got 50 litre overall capacity. That includes the 4 litre freezer. Up here, you've got your freezer. And as I said before, this is 4 litre capacity, and it has an ice tray in there as well for making ice cubes. Underneath the freezer, you've got a little drip tray. So the drip tray comes out and allows you to catch any water once it's defrosting and doesn't go all over the fridge. Just over to the side here, we've got your control knob. Now this is what controls your temperature. It's numbered between 1 and 7. Now 1 is the warmer setting, 7 is the colder setting. On its colder setting, the fridge will go down to 4 degrees, the freezer will go down to minus 12. You have an LED light up here. This is a fault indicator. Now this will flash anywhere between 1 and 5 times, and that'll mean something is wrong with the fridge. Just refer to your workshop manual and it'll explain what it is. And of course, you've got a little LED light up here, which comes on every time you open the door. Just going down here, we've got this shelf. Now this shelf is removable, and you can see you've got 3 different positions here. That's at its lowest setting. We can put that up to its higher setting, and you can actually fit quite a few bottles and cans in here. I'll just show you quickly. If you have a tall bottle, it fits underneath there. You'll see there is a lift up rack there, and you could also lay bottles and cans down low there and still shut the door. Over here on the door, you've got these 2 removable shelves. Now they can be lifted off for cleaning and put back on again. You've also got 2 different positions that can go down low, or you can put it up high. Now, just a word of advice, take that bar out if you're going to do that, because that bar will hit the top of the freezer here when you shut the door. So if you're going to leave that bar in to stop things from falling out, you'll have to keep it down on its lowest shelf down there. Of course, the same thing happens with the bottom. Now we can easily put in a milk bottle down here or a milk carton. Might have to squeeze it in a bit, but that's nice and firm. And you can put a can of drink up there. Once again, might be a bit of a tight, but it does allow you to keep cans and drinks stable while it's inside the fridge. Now that's all I got for you on the DC50-X fridge from Bushman. This fridge has low power consumption, small, lightweight, and big on storage. If you want to find anything more about this or any other products, or you have any questions, go to our website, snowys.com.au, where we have the lowest prices every day.